Test Ride Tuesday again. I've not actually planned to test ride this on a Tuesday, to be honest. I'd planned to ride it the other week and had to cancel. But here we are. We're on a 2018 BMW GS1200 Adventure TE. It's a gobful, isn't it? Essentially, it's the top of the range BMW GS GS Adventure, you know, in the fact that it's got the humongous 30 litre fuel tank, TE, denoting that it's got some of the electronic goodies, I think. Again, this ain't going to be a review. I don't do reviews because I don't get bikes long enough to do a full review on them. It's some initial views, initial impressions of the bike on a test ride. Albeit the kind chaps at BMW in Norwich have let me have it for 2 hours rather than the normal one that most places do. It's probably because it's on a weekday. So I'll go through a few of the bits that I like and I don't like, and I'll probably start with the bits I don't like and do the old knock them down to build them back up sort of thing. And it's going to be a short one because there's not many things I don't like. Probably this thing, the screen. When you compare it to the new Explorer, the 2018 Explorer, this screen's antiquated. It is adjustable, and you can adjust it on the move. There's a knob down here to adjust it up and down, and it does work. Initially, I was getting quite a lot of buffeting and just lifting the screen up. Got rid of that a bit, but there's still a little bit. Quite a lot of wind noise, so I'd probably do what others have done and add a MRA spoiler on it. I think I don't know why they put the adjustment knob there. They could have put it here and would have been easier to use on the move. Perhaps they're trying to discourage you from adjusting it on the move. But yeah, I'm not keen on that. I think it's pretty flimsy, as you can see, it's wobbling about. Albeit it's not a deal breaker, is it? It's only a screen, and there's plenty of stuff out there to change it, and as I've done with my Mark 1 Explorer, so it's not a deal breaker. The other thing, I think, certainly compared with the top of the range Triumph, you get a TFT screen as standard now. This one, how sort of quaint it is. You've got a proper speedo. And BMW do offer a TFT screen, but I think it's somewhat like 400 or 600 quid extra to it daft, whereas the Explorers, it's standard. Little things like that, I suppose, that's it. You know, I said the list would be short. They're really, in what I've had, it's about an hour and 20 minutes now. There's not a lot I've found that I don't like initially about the bike. I think you would have to be riding it a lot longer to find other things that you potentially don't like about it. So I'll move on to all the good bits. Should I just say everything? That'll be it, won't it? A short video. Everything's great. Buy one. No. So what do I do? I think first and foremost, the handling is really nice. Obviously, we all know that the centre of gravity on these is quite a bit lower than an Explorer. It tips in really well, but the big difference for me is at low speed manoeuvring, it feels really well balanced. A lot lighter than you would expect of a bike of this size. But it's that low speed balance, that manoeuvring around U-turns and slow speed moving around. It just feels probably more confidence inspiring than the top heavy, certainly Mark 1 Explorer. The Mark 3 is an improvement, but I think it's still not quite got the low speed sort of agility that this has, if agility is a word you can use with a bike this size. It just feels really easy. It doesn't feel like it's going to topple over. And that's a, you know, confidence inspiring in all the bends that I've been through so far, whether it's low speed or a bit higher. So handling's great. We all know that anyway, don't we? Power. It doesn't feel scary powerful at any point, this bike, to me. Although it is a powerful bike, clearly. It's got lots of low down grunt and it pulls really well in most gears, to be honest. And it's quite smooth. This one's got a quick shifter and it's got an auto blipper when you change down, as long as you've got a closed throttle. And that all works really well. It doesn't, I can tell the difference between this and the Explorer. It doesn't feel as powerful as the Explorer. It doesn't feel I don't feel like it's going to rip your arms out to me. But again, it's like I say, you're not going to complain of a lack of power. Let's see what's around this bend, see if we can get by. Very smooth for a twin cylinder bike. It feels really good. It sounds nice even with a standard Canon. I think it sounded awesome with a more freer breathing can. But you know, as it is, it sounds quite nice when you open the throttle a bit. Switch gears all good. Obviously it's a well tried and tested bike, so all the menus are easy to use. It makes sense, you've got cruise control on the left hand bar. This one's fitted up to accept their navigation system, although obviously the sat nav comes as an extra, which you'd expect. You don't get a sat nav on most bikes, or any bike that I can think of. But it's good that there's a fitment there already on this bike, on the TE. So it's a case of just fitting a sat nav to it. I like that a lot, and I like the fact that it's above the clocks. With the new Explorer, you can't fit a sat nav above the clocks. That's another gripe that I've found out for that bike, and that's one that, until somebody comes up with a method of mounting a sat nav above it, it potentially would put me off the bike, because I don't want a sat nav down on the bars on here. So you've got to take your eyes further away from the road. Yeah, so all the menus are good. It's got decent modes. It's got a dynamic mode, which is essentially a sport mode on this. I've not noticed a huge difference, I have to say, with it. We're in it now. You know, it's supposed to sharpen up the throttle response and things like that, but let's see. I honestly can't tell the difference. Maybe there is a difference, who knows. What else do I like? I like the fact it's got huge grit engine bars already fitted. The Triumph doesn't have that. In fact, I think Triumph have been a little bit cheeky in the way they've said this claim to have saved weight. They've got rid of the things like the engine bars and pannier bars, pannier rails, as standard, and there's no wonder it's lost a bit of weight. So I like the fact that it's already got pannier rails as standard. and the engine bars, which is good. Comfort is bloody lovely, I have to say, so far. I think the one thing I would change, it would be to put a set of bar risers on. I've done a bit of standing on the pegs. Bars are too low for me when I'm stood on the pegs. I'm not an off-road god by any means, but I do like to stand up sometimes. If nothing else, just to give my legs a stretch and my arse a rest. So a set of risers, again, not a deal breaker. The seat feels, it's a standard seat on this, I think, and it feels bloody lovely. And I think a little bit like the new Explorer, because that felt different to mine. They've just reshaped them a bit, and certainly BMW, this seat, it just feels more arse shaped, if that makes sense. It sort of, it cups your buttocks really nicely. Ooh, cups my buttocks. And I don't know what the padding is. I don't know if it's a comfort seat on this or not at the minute. I'll ask when I get back to the shop. But as I say, I think it's more to do with the shape of the seat than anything else. And it just feels good. It feels like I could ride further on this seat than I could on mine without getting the normal aches that you would get. Which is handy because it's got a 30 litre tank on this. Another thing that I like about this GS Adventure is the fact that it's got more fuel range, and it's not particularly because I want to ride 300 or 400 miles in one hit. It's just to have the option of not needing to fill up every 170, 180 miles. I think my bike is a bit overprotective, if you like, with the fuel estimation. It was showing nearly empty on mine the other day, but I filled up and I only got 15 litres in it. And I'd done 160 odd miles. I've had more out of it. I've had 220 miles out of the tank on the Explorer, so I know it'll go a bit further, and that's not a bad... not a bad amount of mileage to be doing on a tank full of juice and a motorbike. But the option with this is it just gives you that comfort of knowing you're not really going to get caught short unless you are going around the world in the back of beyond, or unless you're a complete bell end and just don't fill up. So that's another thing I like about this. There's not a lot to dislike. I think you know, it's a well proven motorbike that everybody knows is good now. You don't get to be the best selling bike for no reason. Would it tempt me to join the dark side? Join me, I am your father. I don't know. Because that the new 2018 Explorer is really, really good, I have to say. And I really liked it. I think the handling, there's nothing to choose between them really, those two on the handling. This one probably is slightly easier to use at lower speed manoeuvring. Albeit the Explorer has closed the gap by a long, long way now. It's really very close. So, you know, that wouldn't put me off either bike. And once you're out on the road, there's really nothing much to choose between them at all. I think one thing I like about this is you get a bit more engine braking with the twin cylinder bike. So you can roll off and it'll slow you down a little bit more. You don't have to grab for the brakes all the time. And I've noticed that following one of my mates. He's on a GS. He hardly ever brakes going into corners, and it catches me out sometimes because I don't have the same engine braking on the triple, and I sometimes need to grab a little handful. So I'll try and find somewhere to stop in a minute and just do a little walk around. And we all know what a GS looks like, for God's sake, but I had wanted to take out a triple black today, but to sort of really hit home with a Star Wars theme on my video. But they didn't have one. They only got this. They have got a triple black in, but it's a second hand bike, and I don't think they like letting the second hand bikes out. You know, quite rightly, they don't want the mileage to go up because it's going to reduce what they can get for them. Yeah, that engine braking's nice. So yeah, I wanted to come out of the triple black, but I've got this red and black one, which is that's actually quite nice. I've never been a massive fan of red bikes, but I just nipped home to pick the camera and the voice recorder up, and my little lad likes it. But again, his favourite colour is red, so. Does tip in well. What time are we on? Time to think about heading back, I think. But say we'll try and find somewhere. That would have done, wouldn't it? See if we can find anywhere in Starston. I don't really want to go right into Harleston if I can help it, but we might end up going through it and getting on the 143 and getting a lick on back up to BMW in Norwich. The one bike I do want to check out after this at some point is a new Urban GS, the retro one. Really like the looks of that, and I think if money were no object, I'd probably have something like that as a second bike if I was really posh and all that. I think it really looks the part. I love the retro look of that. It's got the old air cooled engine, so it's going to sound pretty bloody awesome, I would have thought. So I'll just leave this running and shut up for a bit until I can find somewhere half decent to stop. Quite know what this bloke's playing at. Oh, we're in a 30 limit, that's why. And he's sticking to 20. So yeah, I'll shut up until I can find somewhere to stop and just do a quick walk around and edit it down later. So we might be binning the walk around. I think we all know what a GS looks like anyway, don't we? So, this is a red one. We don't need to walk around and look at a motorbike. There's pictures online, just Google it. Look at somebody else's video. So, in summary then, I'll cut it down a bit, because I need to get a spurt on here and get back up to Norwich really. I'm a bit late. It's a cracking bike. I really like it. Bags of power, great handling, it's really comfy, sounds nice. I quite like the looks. I still prefer the Explorer looks. I think it's just a bit neater. This one kind of looks a bit higgledy-piggledy. It certainly looks rugged, it looks the part. But I just think the Explorer looks a little bit neater, a bit more refined in the looks department. But overall, I really like this. Would I have one? Yeah, definitely. Would I have one instead of a 2018 Explorer? Not sure. The new Explorer really is a peach of a bike. I already know I like Triumph anyway. I like Triumph triples. So it would have to come down to, I think, what sort of deal I could get from either manufacturer, either sort of dealer, as to whether I go for BMW or Triumph. Because there really isn't an awful lot to choose between these two bikes as far as how good they are is concerned. They're both awesome. So there we go. Test ride Tuesday, BMW, a 2018 BMW GS1200 Adventure TE. It's a cracking bit of kit. I'll see you.